Alrighty guys, welcome to the stream. I am just continuing getting set up here, so it'll be just a few moments. Get that radio voice in here.
Yeah.
Hey, what is up guys?
It's like those cheesy YouTube videos that get a lot of views.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
I always have that voice, man. It just attracts those 12-year-olds, and they're like, oh my gosh, this guy's entertaining already.
Yeah, but I don't want to attract 12-year-olds. That sounds pedophilic.
Right. So far, that's all we've done, though. We're watching.
Fair enough. Well, that's all you've done.
Yeah, I guess so.
How's that make you feel?
Turn the tables on me. I don't know what to say to that. Okay, what is up, MM Guitar? This is the homie Momo, Mauricio Martin, aka Cheesecake, aka Cream Pie. How's it going, man? Just doing a Zen sketch with the homie Jake from Watch Me Free Work. He works in 3D, works in Blender, open source software, strictly. That's what you guys call it, right? Open source?
Yeah.
Okay.
Open source is a good term to use, I would say. Maybe? I don't know.
We'll go with it.
Yeah. Whatever works.
Right. MM Guitar says it's lemon meringue pie to you.
Oh?
So he is a trisexual cheesecake lemon meringue pie.
Wow. Trisexual, huh?
Trisexual, man. Who said that? who said that one thing? I only identify my gender as attack helicopter.
Oh, that was a meme from like 2003 or something like that.
Damn.
Yeah.
Way to make me feel out of the loop, man.
That's been a meme since before Newgrounds.
Newgrounds, man.
Mm-hmm.
One of my friends put out his animation on Newgrounds and tried to get me to start animating, but just don't have the time to learn animation yet. Too much work. Chris says, what is more likely to get a job showing off skills in all areas like modeling, rendering, lighting, rigging, animation, etc., or just very good in detailed modeling, showing very good knowledge of anatomy, etc.? What is easier to get into? I'll let you answer, Jake, since you're more on the 3D side for like modeling and rigging. You probably know more than me than that.
I would say to get a job is to build a portfolio. Like, that's your first step, is to show off what you can do. And this goes for art, this goes for just about anything. If you're looking for work, you build a portfolio.
Right.
Because that's gonna get your foot in the door, and showing that you can actually understand armature and understand how things fit together to where they look natural, especially if you're doing like human modeling. Or humanoid modeling, rather. That is probably your best bet, is to go down the route of trying to show off your skills in a portfolio. Hopefully that I answered the question.
Yeah,
I think so.
Pretty much what I was going to say. One more thing that I've heard people say, too, about portfolios, like, seems like you're asking Chris more of like a question of should I be more of a specialist or a generalist, and
specialist.
I think so you do want to have a specialization, because that'll differentiate you from other people. But I think in the start it's good to have a general grasp on things to know where you want to go to specialize, but I think ultimately you want to have a specialization and hone in that skill extremely well with time, though. So, I'm just starting out. I'm trying to build that portfolio like Jake's talking about, which will hopefully land me a job and hopefully enter myself into new arenas of digital art, concepting, illustration, whatever it be, and then I can find my specialization once I have the skills. But I am trying to specialize a little bit into character art. That's where I've been leaning to a little bit lately, but I do want to have that general grasp of like environments so I can be a little bit versatile. But yeah, being specialized in something, I think that's gonna be a lot of power. I'm a guitar. What if I only play guitar and that's it?
Then play guitar. Enjoy it.
Go.
Do what you love. And if you want to make money doing guitar, then go out on the street, pound the pavement, and play some songs.
That's what's up.
That's the best way to get your start if you want to be a guitarist. And eventually, somebody from a bar is going to come up to you and be like, I have an opening this weekend if you want to play, if you're good. If you're terrible, then you realize maybe it's not going to be financially stable, and maybe you shouldn't do it.
But keep at it.
But yeah, keep at it. Do it for you. Because if you're doing it to build an audience and do it for just the money, you're not going to like it come 6 months into it.
Yeah. And that can be interpreted to pretty much
everything.
Any field as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Money comes as a byproduct, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, I don't see me making any profit from this because I'm going to publish it as an open source minigame for on stream. For Watch Me Work streamers and really just anybody who wants it. And two, I'm just doing it because I really want to make a game and this is my first start. Granted, money is be all end all of the world, apparently, but yeah.
Yeah, that's the only thing. But I think MM Guitar might be kidding with us now. He said, I only know how to play kid songs, so.
Well, play some kid songs then. Play your heart out. Enjoy it. I'm sure that there's plenty of schools or daycares that would love to have a live guest. To keep the kids entertained, that way the teachers can have a break.
That'd actually be a good idea.
Yeah. Plenty of schools do it. It's what the whole assembly thing is for, just so the teachers can have a little bit of a break from dealing with the kids.
Pretty much. I get overwhelming, man.
Yeah.
Kids can be a little bit too much sometimes. That's why, like, it's good to be a teacher, but, like, not to have kids.
Sorry, guys.
That's at least my view on it.
I'm doing math on my phone. Trying to figure out what size I'm gonna make this. What size is my screen at? Start there. Okay, so it's 1080 by
12. Oh guys, I also got the Twitch alerts to work now, so if you follow you'll get a little endorphin boost from your name. Being blasted on top of my stream.
I like it.
It's an incentive. Okay, so what I'll do again is I'll use lasso tool to go over this area that's going to be the fabric, and I'll show you how I'm just going to make these tones a lot darker so I have a little bit more variation. Control L once I have that, and then so it's only doing a certain area. Oh well, we can fix that.
Okay. I'll be able to fit 8 layers on top of each other, so Math. Gotta love it.
So fun. I miss it. I miss calc.
Oh, yeah?
Not really.
Just, I don't know what to say to that. All right. Well, okay then. Okay. So this is going to be 1080 high. We know that for sure. I miss algebra. But then again, I still do it, so I can't really say that I miss it now that I think about it. Eh, whatever. Whatever.
How dare you.
I still miss it. It's still great. What are common resolutions for a computer? I got 1080 by 1920. It's 1920 by 1080. Let's go 720? Maybe?
And then guitar. What did you say? Yeah. Keeping yourself open to side gigs, having connections is a really good start. But in music, it's really what's available and what you can do to provide that. Yeah. Opportunity. Opportunity is a huge thing, and that's where it comes down to luck. Also, it's a huge part of it. But then again, luck doesn't matter if you don't have the skills.
It's not going to be 1080. I was completely wrong. Which is always good. How many pixels is that then? Let's go. Pixel. Six, seven, eight, 10? Is 10 a good number? Okay. Goodness. Why? Oh, that's why. So that's 10. 11. Okay. So 1080 minus 11 is...
MM Guitar? Yeah, I did get to see the Killing Joke. I think I saw it with you guys. If you're talking about the animation, then yeah.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
This could work. Yeah. And then 11069. That... No, it's just 1069. Okay, good. So now, if I view show grid, you are at the wrong dimensions. Configure grid at 16. Okay. Those are our dimensions for this. Sweet. Now, I'm going to try and find a way to do this properly. Find a good sand color. I think we're just gonna color pick to do this, because I'm bad with color.
It's a good way to learn it, though. It's actually a really good way.
Yeah. I'm still bad with color. Like, I've been studying color for so long, and I'm still just awful at it.
Yeah, like, there's always something to discover. I think we were talking about that before, like, how sometimes blacks or blues or deep reds.
Yeah.
Pretty crazy.
Could go with a purplish. Nah. I don't want to go with the purplish. I want to go with the generalized. This is the ocean. But who's to say that the purple ground is not the ocean? Besides scientists.
Deep. Deep.
Very deep. Like 20 knots or something like that.
Oh, God.
Okay. So let's do a new layer. Sure, why not? Control B. Dang it. File open. Losing my voice again. Clients, me. Yes, I put myself under clients folder. Because organization and stuff.
Oh, I'm pretty anal about that, too.
Let's go ahead and shrink this down. Move this over here. Bring that up. Move this over here. Bring this over here. And bring this over here. I like that sound.
Yeah.
Yeah. You bring it over meow and you put it over meow.
Yeah.
Okay. So we color pick from here and then we modify it slightly. Let's go a bit darker with it. Let's go a bit greener with it and maybe a tinge less red. A bit more yellow, maybe? I don't know what I'm doing, guys. Okay. So, we are going to go by 4 times, I think? Yeah, 4 times is going to be good. How do I snap to a different kind of grid than what's showing?
You're not using Photoshop, are you?
No, I'm using GIMP. I know this has a function to do it, but I don't remember how. Does anybody know how to snap it to a separate grid from the regular, like the main grid? Because I'm trying to do a 4x4 pixel block, and I want to just be able to move it like it's a 1x1. Just because it'd be a lot simpler. Let us go ahead and we'll just select this sand color for now. I think I want to bring it up to about right there. Should be good. Okay. Well, that did not work. Why did that not work? I don't know.
Alright, Jake. Alright, chat. I'm gonna take a quick, like, 5-minute break. I'm gonna put the slideshow on. I'll be right back.
Alright. See you in a bit. Let's just start with this. Let's get the general background taken care of. I think that's gonna be our best bet. Let's switch to a darker color. Let's go with a bluish hue to it. I guess I gotta figure out how tall the character's going to be, don't I? Put this back here. See about right there. How does that look? Then we'll have the water coming in about right there ish. Kinda like that. I think that's gonna be able to fit a person on, and our fish and everything. Let's see. 128 by 128 is going to be 116. 16 goes into 128 like 8 times, right? Yeah. So it's going to be an 8x8 square. Oh wow. That's big. The fish in this game are going to be big. Apparently. Alright. Means that the character, I mean, I guess we could make the character smaller. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're probably going to want to go down. Where our water level will be and our land level will be right there. Yeah? I think that'll work. That kind of removes a lot of space, though. Game design decisions. Or we could make the character really, really small, too. That's another option. Decisions. Also, I thought I did the grid to 16 pixels by 16 pixels. What? Pixels per inch, no? Yeah. Did I mess up somehow? I'm starting to feel like I messed up somehow. Try this again. Let's change how many pixels we have per inch. Let's do it that way. Yep. So if I show grid and image configure grid, put it to 16, that looks better. I have to completely redo what I was doing, but that's okay. And it's weird that it's scaling oddly on my stream. Is that how you guys view that? Huh. I have to find a better system for that then. So let's redo all of this stuff. Put this over here.
Hi, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Go OBS and get the start. Let's fill this whole page up in a night, guys.
Yeah. Ooh. Sketchbook.
Oh yeah.
So how'd your dinner date go?
Dinner date? Oh, yeah. With mommy.
Yeah.
Mexican food, man.
Awesome.
Pretty good. Yeah, it's a good day. She enjoyed it, so that's all that matters.
Is it weird to call that a dinner date?
It works.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Huh.
I think date has a weird connotation to it.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's kind of
weird.
Okay. Alright. Well, at least we're on the same page.
Yeah, it doesn't bother me too much, so I'm not that type of person.
Okay. So why is it that I've set my settings to 16 pixels per inch, and I have a brush that's 16 pixels, it's a 16 pixel square, yet it doesn't fill up the grid that's at 16 pixels.
Wait, so you did what? You have 16 pixels per square inch for your canvas?
Yes.
And you have a 16 pixel wide brush?
Uh-huh. And my grid's set to 16 pixels by 16 pixels.
Wouldn't that fill up the whole page? With just one brush?
No.
No?
No, that's the PPI I have for it, but it's a, it's like 7, or, a little bit under 1080 by 1120, and snowy blue. I can't read that. That's super tiny. Let me change that and make it bigger. But thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. So from now on, you will be called Snowy. Because I cannot read. That is very interesting. So if I go 17 though, that's still too small. 20 is wrong on so many levels. Does 21 fit? No. 23 is too big. I will get down to the bottom of this. Why is this a thing? Why is this happening? What am I missing? Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, Snowy Blossom. And again, thank you so much for the follow. How's your evening going? And I'll mute for this stuff. My bad.
No problem.
So what do you do there, Snowy? Image, configure grid. It's a 16:1 inch ratio, yeah. Oh, that's actually a cool way to do the grid. That's a weird way to do the grid. Yeah, I like the solid. Let's just get into it. No sense dilly-dallying. Let's go with that color. Let's go here, to here-ish, to here-ish, to here-ish. Shift? It is shift. Sweet. Move that down. Almost 2 a.m. for you. Awesome.
Thanks.
Well, thank you for joining. Hope you enjoy it. Hope my amazing commentary. I can't even say that with a straight face. Yeah. Put that there and stroke the path. So we switch to that. We remove our grid. That's kind of sort of how it's going to look. Give or take. I wonder if I should switch this down to a much lower resolution. Actually. Like, do the background as the same kind of settings. Might be what I do. We're gonna try this again. Because it's not the third time that I'm doing this. Just trying to get this right. Okay, so. Would I do it PPP? Pixels per point? Would that be how I would go about it? I don't know. I don't know these things. Alright. 8 times 120 each. Actually, 16 times 8 will be 128. Of course it will. Of course, 1024. Okay. We'll try it. $7.68. Okay. And of course it does the color that I don't want because, you know, reasons. Or raisins, depending on how you feel. Okay. You show grid, image, configure grid. So if I put that to 16 by 16, should have a grand total of 128 divided by 16 equals 8. Times 8 is 64. So yeah, that's right. Cool. I'm doing well. Just enjoying working on pixel art. It's my newfound hobby when I'm not working on a game, which I probably should be doing, but I'm kind of procrastinating. Because, yeah. Doesn't work that way. I'll just do it pixel by pixel, I guess. Let's add some hills there, add some hill here, and this is actually going to taper off about right there. So if we grab an eraser, go up to, I don't know, 3 should be enough. And do that. And then we will have. Okay, that's fine. That there. And. Oops. I done goofed. Are you not connected on this side? Of course you're not. Why would you be? Okay. So we're going to have sand there and a nice ugly yellow. Let's go ahead and figure out the location of this now. So, the character's going to be pretty small compared to the fish. I want it to be really identifiable that the fish are, well, where the fish are. So the character's not really going to matter all that much, so I think we're going to put the character like right there. The favorite thing I've drawn or done. I'm actually a 3D modeler. That's my main specialty. My favorite thing that I've ever drawn or made is when I was in architectural design school. I had this really awesome dream house, quote unquote. Was the project that we were working on, and it turned out beautiful. There were all sorts of archways, and it kind of had a Baroque feel to it. Not that I know the term. But yeah, that was probably my best work. And it was all to scale, because in architectural design, everything has to be to scale. So yeah, I would say that would be my favorite thing that I've ever drawn. But I really like that Baroque style. Especially in modeling, because then you get to see the full 3D version of it, which is amazing. Yeah, it was flipping epic. I sound so weird saying that. have some sort of curvature there. Have a nice rocky face to it. And that's going to be non-playable area. We could throw another non-playable area here, but I don't think I want to do that. I think it just needs to be on one side. And that'll be pretty good. Right now I'm just designing how the game will look, so trying to figure out all the things. So go with a lightish blue, maybe go along that scale, a bit lighter and a bit wider. And this will be around here. It'll be the darker version of the ocean, and the lighter version will be a more tealish color, like that, going up there, something like that. I actually think I want to do a straight line here and add to that. Okay. So next, I'm going to want to throw some things on the sand eventually. Which will be fun. Let's just go into texturing the sand. Let's just hop right into it. Let's go with the more orangish color. How's that look? Yeah. And pixel by pixel, here we go. The really fun and enjoyable part of this, right? That's a much better yellow. I like that. Okay, let's grab this yellow. Let's go a tinge darker with it and a bit more on the orangish value scale. Throw in all my little Tetris pieces. And already we have some grain in our sand. Sweet. So this is my first attempt on doing everything off the top of my head and not following any sort of tracing guide. And hopefully it turns out alright. Yeah, I've done three fish by tracing, and I did the rest of that fin pretty well just by eyeballing it, so I think I'm competent enough to.
Gotta spread those wings, man.
Yeah, absolutely. So, what's your favorite thing to draw there, Snowy? Too much of an eye. Oh, I was just asking the same question that you asked me. No problem. I understand getting focused on your work. I'm definitely one of those people. I like how I start at the area where it's probably not even going to show. This is my testing grounds, I guess. Okay. Let's go ahead and grab this color then. And move it up more toward the green, I think? Is that too green? That's way too green. A little bit more yellow, yeah. That's still way too green, actually. There we go, that's the sand color we want. That looks good from a distance, I like that. And I'm trying to be as random as I possibly can, but given the human condition, it's really hard to do that. It's already turning out really cool. Awesome. So how's your project going?
Coming up to little walls of frustration, but trying to get over them.
Yeah.
Figure out how to draw these characters and whatnot. Get this page done before I go to sleep.
Yeah. What you having a problem with? Oh, it's coming great. I love it.
It's good.
I love it already, and I've only done like 20 or 30 pixels.
Nice. but I think the frustration's coming with like proportion problems. Glad you asked that. That's how I can like think about what's mm-hmm. wrong with it.
That's why I asked it, because sometimes you just gotta take a seat back and look at something.
Yeah, exactly, man.
And realize what you're doing wrong, that way you can fix it yourself.
Yeah, it's a huge part of getting over those hurdles, definitely.
Yeah, if pixel art wasn't so like very detailed and very specific of where you place the pixels, I would definitely do it blindfold, but it's kind of hard to just do that.
Yeah.
Do you have any other ways that you would do randomness? Like any tips and tricks?
Are you talking to
you.
Me or?
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
For randomness, and like, when I think of randomness, I think of spontaneity. When I think of that, I think of gesture.
Mm-hmm.
And gesture, again, goes back to that spontaneity of just like kind of putting in like a random line or just a feeling. But that's more like drawing, I guess. For like color palettes too, just like putting colors together and seeing which ones give harmony together.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you're too familiar with like analogous colors, mm-hmm. colors that are close to each other.
Oh, yeah.
Stuff like that. So you can experiment too. Experimenting helps a lot to get that that randomness.
Interesting.
I hope that helps.
No, that actually makes a lot of sense. Doesn't really help me, but it makes a lot of sense. and it's something I'll use eventually. No, I don't like that. Okay. Let's start moving on further down, because I think I'm gonna overwork that area if I continue on going down that path. Actually, that's kind of cool. Let's put that up there. Ever heard of Buffy the Vampire Slayer? Of course I have. It was a great show until it wasn't.
Ouch.
It got really bad towards the last two seasons. Which at that point it had, what, 8 seasons? So, yeah. It's kind of to be expected, in a way. Okay. Sure, we'll throw some extra bits on this one. That'll be a big grain of sand. Why not? Oh, sweet. I'm already on season 3, huh? Yeah, it's been a while since I've watched it. Might get back into it. It was a really good show back in the day. So was Charmed. I grew up on Charmed. I used to have such the biggest crush on Piper when I was a kid.
Still haven't seen either of those shows.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
I'd like to, though. Take some time to watch them.
Yeah, it's a pretty good show. Both of them. Have you seen Supernatural?
Have not.
That's another interesting, good one. It's got a more, like, grotesque feel to it, which is why I like it, I think.
Have you seen the new Netflix series Stranger Things?
No.
I think I brought that up before.
Yeah, I really want to see it.
Super good.
Yeah, that's what I hear. But then I have to download Netflix and get an account with Netflix again, and laziness, you know.
Right.
I was starting to focus way too much on not being the same, and I think that was causing some issues, so I think I'm just gonna do my thing and not care. Not care if it's the same. I could keep trying to do randomness, but it's not gonna happen. No matter how much I try. I have so much more to go. Oh my goodness. The spinoff Angel when he left Buffy for his own show. Oh yeah, that got it caused some controversy in our household. Because some people were very mad that he was no longer in the show and they didn't want to watch it because he was only good in Buffy, and some people were like, it doesn't really matter because he's doing his own thing and it's actually a pretty decent show. Pretty much that was just me, but yeah. Plus, then, didn't Buffy go and date some other demon, and it was kind of just like, oh yeah, we replaced him. I think that's what got me off of the show. It was because they didn't, like, continue on with the storyline, they just kind of were like, oh, well, he no longer wants to work with us, so who can we find that can replace him and be the same exact character? It's like, we already had an Angel. We don't need whoever the hell he was.
Hey, what's up, Jeff Friend 34? You didn't make it back on. I'm on right now.
Yeah?
Yeah?
You're even live on Watch Me Work, so.
Yeah, I think I'm on Twitch too.
Yeah.
Shows I'm online. So how's it going, man?
Riley, yeah. The other bad boy. I haven't thought about that show in years. My goodness. I'm old. I'm young, but I'm old.
Old soul.
I guess so.
Tefram, are you drawing along with me, or just chilling, doing your thing? Oh, you watched my earlier stream. That's right. Yeah, you were in here too. Yeah. Oh, cool, you get the notification. So that's good to know. Yeah, man, pull out that sketch card, start drawing. Get those juices flowing.
It's amazing what those Tetris pieces look like from a distance.
I know. I know, that's magic, man.
So cool.
Visual magic. don't know what to work on, one of the best remedies is just looking up images and just drawing anything. Once you start drawing something, it allows you to move on to other things as well. At least that's what works for me. As long as I keep my pen moving, whether that's a comp pen or any other pen, I can just keep going. Just gotta start that train. Keep chugging along.
Yeah, Tetris always changes lives. The best game ever made, some would argue.
So simple, too. Such mm-hmm. a simple game design.
Yeah, most of the best games are really simple.
Yeah.
At least from our era. These new games are pretty amazing, though, I have to say.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Just the amount of hands that are working on this game.
Yeah.
It's pretty incredible.
Yeah, that has a lot to do with it, too. Yeah, sure, why not?
The static feeling when you get in, or when you can't get into the zone. Yeah, Tefram. Yeah, dude, it sucks, like. When you get out of the rut, or when you get into that rut of not really feeling it, it can be very discouraging. But it's just as simple as starting up again. But you just gotta have that willpower to do it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And remind yourself like why you're doing it. Like it's fun. Like you're doing it because it's fun. And make sure you have fun while you're doing it. You could trick your brain into believing that it's still fun.
You can trick your brain into believing it's fun. I like it.
Yeah, yeah. It works. It really does.
Oh, yeah. The music from Tetris? Oh. Don't get me started on 8-bit music. Oh. I love a new game that has a good 8-bit track. Like, Spelunky's fairly new. And it has a whole series of 8-bit tracks for special levels, which is just amazing.
Yeah, Tefram, if you get impatient, like, that's why I'm doing these drawings. Like, some of these are taking a little bit longer, and I can come back to them as well. But, like, this one right here probably took me, like, a minute. This one down here. But, yeah, you can draw fast, you can draw slowly and take your time on things. But nice little doodles are really cool. Like thumbnails, these are little thumbnails, kind of. I just blew it up a little bit. Hope that helps.
I think I see why pixel artists do Tetris pieces. I think I figured it out. Because if you just hold down the mouse for a few seconds while you're drawing it, it just kind of automatically does it by the time you let it out.
So you kind of like drag them to create the shapes?
Yeah.
Nice.
Like you still have to have that basic shape, but... Huh. Interesting. Nice.
Right, and Tefram, like, usually it's the sketches that lead on to larger works.
Mm-hmm.
So, you don't always have to come out with the idea that you're going to make a finished work. Just start drawing, and maybe that idea will, or maybe those thousands of sketches, one of them will be the one you want to really push, and that one might be the most amazing thing you've done.
Holy cow, we're almost to the end of the page.
Yeah, and it's like a transition from, you said, transition from great sketch to finished work. It's usually a shitty sketch that turns into a decent sketch, which gets into a refined sketch, and then you somehow fit that into a composition and then work out color. So it's a long process to get a nice piece if you're not like a crazy fast professional.
Yeah, I completely agree. When a little small doodle, Snowy had said, I love when a small doodle suddenly becomes this project and looks amazing and it was fun to do.
Yeah, and that's like one of the best feelings of seeing your hard work pay off and your ideas really come through.
Mm-hmm.
Which I've only had like a couple of paintings that I've been satisfied that have worked that way. I've thrown away so many pieces of artwork, sad.
Well, you shouldn't be doing that.
I know, it's a bad habit. Color that gets you. There's good books on color, man. Good tutorials too. Just takes practice. Like, yeah, it's a feel thing. You get a feel for color as well. And some colors you'll gravitate towards, and that's what a lot of people call your palette. It's interesting how they call it a palette. Like, if you think about a palette, like what's on your palette when you eat, it's like what you like to taste. Mm-hmm. Same thing with color too.
And that's kind of why they refer to what you like as your taste when it comes to art.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
We haven't delved too much into philosophy this time. It's amazing.
Yeah. It's been, like, super focused. Yeah, I love those talks, man.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ephraim says, I've done grayscale for so long, and it is difficult to see the right values in color. And that's what will allow you to see values in color, is by just doing grayscale. Color is secondary to values. Value is like your fries, and color is like your ketchup. You can't have ketchup alone by yourself. You gotta have the fries or the burger. So think about your values that way. Like, it's foundational. It's like the preliminary stage, actually, to your color. So if you don't know how to do things in value, then you're not gonna... You're just wasting your time with color, really. And a lot of people know how to make form with color intuitively. Like Jake, that's what he's doing with his pixel drawings. And you can see where there's darker purples and then there's lighter purples. So let me give you an example of reds. Let me try to draw something out. So I'll use darker reds. Just to like create a face or something. Okay, so I'll fill in the shadows with my dark reds.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, doing things monochromatically can help you get those values a lot faster, and those forms established a lot faster as well. So see how I'm just using reds? This is like monochrome. This is what I start off a lot of my traditional paintings with, is a monochrome undersketch. Like, I'll use the burnt sienna to do my paintings. And it's good to have that warmth underneath as well. So let me add some of the grays. And grays are actually important to have. Like, usually it's like the nice grays. If you know how to mix grays and control them, usually your paintings turn out really well. Yeah, if you want to improve your color palette, look at what other artists are using. Look at the masters, like Bouguereau, Frazetta, so many. But look at the masters that you like. Don't study someone that you don't like and expect to get something from it.
Mm-hmm. Because if it's not pleasing to you, then whatever you make that's in that style is not going to be ever good.
Exactly. Yeah.
According to
your
point. So...
So, here's my color palette right now, which is grays, right? So I got grays, tephrum, and some reds. So let me introduce something that is called complementary color. So I'll go on the other side of the color wheel, and I'll go in with my blues. And usually it's best to create a relationship between your colors, so usually they work in opposites, especially if they're complementary. So if I have a blue, or like a blue-green, which would be the complement for like an orange, I put that in my shadows. So let me put that in my shadows, and I'll keep my warms in the lights. Dude, if you feel like garbage guessing the right colors, I still feel the same, man. Like, it's something that you keep learning, and you just keep getting better at it. One thing to do that'll get your color picking skills or mixing skills up a lot faster is going out in life, getting like a watercolor sketchbook, some portable watercolors, and studying from life, seeing how life presents itself in color, how nature works with color, and closely observe what colors you're seeing. Don't just see something and paint what you think you see. Paint what you actually see, and that'll get you towards a better understanding of color. And this is a very exaggerated color palette that I'm using. This is something that's completely unrealistic in nature. Like, this would have to be under a controlled lighting scenario or something like that.
And if you ever want to do pixel art, what I'm doing here is I'm just kind of letting the brush go where it wants to go. Like, I'm clicking whenever there's a blank space, or in this case, the yellow background, and then letting go at random times. And that's been probably the best thing that I've noticed works.
So is that how you've been, or you've been getting your randomness?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Which is interesting, because again, I've never done this before, so I'm still learning. I'm trying to find what groove works, and this seems to be working pretty well. Starting to become really happy with how it's turning out, so.
That's good, that's good.
I wouldn't call it a masterpiece by any means, and probably never will, but...
Not yet, at least.
Yeah. It's possible that that could happen, but I'm way too hard on myself.
Same. Yeah. But, Tephrim, if you saw, like, that was a pretty garbage painting, but for some reason people are, like, I don't know, amazed by those types of things, but...
Yeah, I find that I feel that a few things that I'm working on are garbage, and then I get compliments up the wazoo because it's exactly what my client wants. And I don't argue with them because, one, they provide the money, but...
Yeah.
But, two, I want to make sure that they like what they have and they get the best quality, which is good for any business.
Exactly.
So, and sometimes I feel like it's not good enough, and then I get this compliment of, oh yeah, it's exactly what I wanted. Like, okay, well, I mean, I could have done better, I think, maybe. But if you like it, you like it, so.
Yep.
So yeah, taking somebody else's opinion over your own is always a good thing to keep in mind when you're doing artistic and creative things.
Definitely.
Hey, Vast, the Vast Unknown. I would appreciate if you did not say things like that in my chat. And if that continues, then I'll have to ban you, which I really don't want to do, because I have to access Twitch and all that fun stuff, so.
Bomber.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah,
don't
it's
cry.
Funny, dude, because, like, the stuff that, like you say, it's funny how others, like, the work that I detest, and that's how it is with the people that I look up to as well. And it's, like, it's honest when I'm, like, saying it. Like, I really feel like I could do better,
mm-hmm.
or, like, I've done better already. Maybe that's the case. Or I just know I can do better, and I'm just slacking it.
Yeah.
Whatever.
There are certain times where you do feel like you're slacking, and that's the time to maybe, before you send it off to somebody and you really don't think it's right because you know you can do better, to push yourself to do better on it.
Yeah.
But trying to find the right
time
to
reevaluate that.
Yeah. But finding the right time can be hard sometimes. The right time to decide if it's just you didn't do good enough, or if it's just you thinking that you didn't do good enough.
Yeah. And he made another good point too. He said that he knows that everything is subjective, and what you see isn't what others see. That's
yeah,
a,
absolutely.
A great point as well. Everyone has their own lens. They're coming from their own place. Knowledge.
Yeah, exactly, Snowy. Yeah. The best thing to do is get somebody else's opinion. If you're working for somebody, and like me, whenever I like right before I'm about to send something, I post it in a chat and see people's opinion and see what they say.
Oh, smart. Yeah, getting other people's feedback that you trust.
Yeah. Unless I have a deadline, then I have a deadline. I have to make it, so I don't have the time. But yeah. That's been my way of doing things, is just trying to get other people's opinion and trying to find how I can do better, because needless to say, nobody's perfect. Nobody will get it right the first time, and a lot of the things that I do are first time I'm just trying it out. That is your second warning, Vast, please. Trying to keep this an appropriate stream, so. I think they call that a fist pound. I don't know. I'm not good with terminology.
You mean a
all the
fist
things
hashtag?
That they... No. Absolutely not. Wait, is that from Always Sunny? I should know this. It's a good show. I should watch that again.
Are you talking about Always Sunny in Philadelphia?
Yeah.
I saw a couple episodes. The shit's funny, man.
Yeah, it is a fist bump. Ha! Huh, I got my terminology right. Nice.
Nice.
Well, there it is. You can't see it because I don't have a webcam, but there it is. And I'm sorry for getting irritated about that, or threatening to ban you, but trying to avoid having to do all that management stuff, because this is just a fun little stream that I've been doing, and I want to keep it that way. I don't want to have to be that asshole. So how's your day going so far? The vast unknown? Sorry. Get too focused and forget names. Do you do art stuff? And if so, what do you do?
What do you mean, Tefram? Sounds like that person is really pushing it in the other stream we're listening to. Not too sure what you mean by that.
No, he popped into the chat, or she popped into the chat, and just started the whole conversation with Fismu.
Oh.
So, I'm just like, please keep it appropriate.
Yeah.
There are kids on the internet, so...
Oh, you hear another stream, Tef. Yeah, this is that's a homie Jake. He's on a similar channel called Watch Me Work.
Yeah.
And this is good to have another person in the chat. Like, even if I'm not talking back to him, just to hear his voice, knowing that he's working on something is very reassuring.
Aww.
Yeah.
You just want to hear my voice. Aww.
I just need people, man.
The bromance.
True romance via internet.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's actually in a Discord chat with me.
Yep. Good old Discord chat.
Yeah.
So much better than Skype.
Oh, it is. Dude, it's so much better.
That's looking pretty good. It's looking a little scarce in this area, though. Need to add some more to it. Throw some on top here. See how that turns out.
Yeah, Skype can burn for all I care. Yeah, I agree, man. Yeah.
Yep.
Discord. Discord's awesome. I love the UI, too. It's such a comfy UI.
Mm-hmm. And programming for it's really, really easy, apparently.
Yeah. Yeah, I like the Watch Me Works Discord. Like, it's very organized.
Yeah. Well, thank you. I'm glad you like it.
Yeah, it's legit, man.
We still have things to tweak out for it. That way we can set up inviting viewers during a stream and stuff.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool. Just like randoms at least or something.
Yeah. Because at the moment we have a gated system, so like an admin has to change what they have. By the way, did I make you an admin yet?
I'm not too sure.
You are now an admin. Enjoy it. Don't overuse it. Otherwise, you'll be demoted.
Aw, oh, man. Gotcha. You can trust me.
But, like, if you want to create a channel, you can. As an admin.
Okay.
So.
I see.
if you just want to go be by yourself, you can do that.
Okay. Gotcha.
Kind of the idea behind it. Or if you want to do, like, a private chat with somebody and don't want other people to join except for, like, other admins, because they can join every channel.
That could be very convenient, actually.
Yeah. Trying to make this as streamer-friendly and people-friendly as possible.
Nice.
Which I think it's turning out alright.
Yeah, it is, man.
It's amazing that just this little bit of sand that I'm adding in is only like an eighth of the entire piece. And I've spent so long on it. I think this is probably gonna be a month long project.
Yeah,
maybe
close to an end, but I could still go. I have a lot of blank spaces on my sketchbook page.
You said you were gonna fill it.
Yep, gotta fill it somehow. I could just enlarge in everything and rearrange them, but I'm not gonna be cheap. Not today.
That's cheating. Can't do that.
Tephrom, and it works on my OS, so it's a win-win for me. What do you have, Linux? Or are you using just like a regular, average Joe Windows OS? That's what I'm using. I'm using Windows 10. I actually like it a lot.
Yeah, Windows 10 is great.
It's nice. Runs games well.
I have yet to have any serious problems with it yet. So.
Yeah, it's nice. I like it. He does have Linux. He said he can't stand Windows. Respect.
Yeah. You know what you want. It's more than most people. So.
Oh, yeah.
There's the philosophy we've been needing.
And there it comes. So I was looking at the stars last night, man. I was thinking how I'm just, like, one of them among the million, bro. And, like, it's all meaningless, but it's so meaningful, bro.
Yeah, so. Man. It's just, like, everything could be completely pointless. Like, what if we were in a computer, man?
Dude, that's crazy to think, like, there's this one talk by Dan Harmon, one of the creators for Rick and Morty.
Mm-hmm.
And he was saying like the solution for like eternity will be when we create a simulation that slows down time. Like, you know how computers process information at a crazy rate? Like, when we're able to put our consciousness in a computer and slow it down to a rate that's just a fraction of a fraction of a fraction of a fraction, like of a second or like a millisecond.
Mm-hmm.
Like, say if the Earth's ending, like life on Earth is going to end soon, like the sun's going to turn into red giant right now, we just like hook up and live pretty much for eternity, theoretically for eternity, just
like, personally, I think that the world will like planet Earth will decide that that's not going to be a good thing before we're able to develop that technology.
True.
But maybe that's just a pessimistic. Yeah, kinda.
Yeah.
But maybe that's just the pessimist in me thinking that.
It's a realistic position, too.
Yeah.
I think so.
Pessimist, realist. I mean, what's the difference, honestly?
Fuck, really? damn. Jeez.
Yeah. I'm probably more cynical than I would like to be. So.
Yeah, same. I just try to lie to myself that I'm not one.
Yeah, absolutely. That's all you can do, right?
That's what gets me by, I guess.
The problem with us and our jokes is nobody can really tell if we're being facetious or not.
I know. Sometimes I can't tell, honestly.
Let's see. That looks pretty good there. Sure, why not?
Man, I've learned a lot in this entire week just by coming on here every day and sketching.
Yeah. It's really nice to have somebody to talk to while I'm working on this stuff, too.
Yeah, it helps out a lot, doesn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. I probably would have given up on this 2 hours ago, honestly.
Same, dude.
Because it's frustrating trying to get these shapes right. Like,
yeah,
just
man,
the simple Tetris pieces.
Yeah, especially when they're just like one pixel. Like, it comes down to one pixel.
Yeah. And then you zoom out and you realize that, oh my gosh, I have so much work to do.
Yeah.
It's overwhelming at times.
Do you have like a navigator tool where you can see like the greater picture of your pixel drawing? Or your pixel painting?
I don't know if Gimp has that. I know that there's a plugin for it, but I don't know if it has it as default. Which, if there's a plugin, I would assume not.
That's what I use for painting, too. Like, for the sketchbook to see where I'm at on the page and seeing how it's all coming together. But
yeah,
Go ahead.
No, it's all good.
Okay, so Tefren, what we're saying, likes to make the system the way he wants it. I agree. That's smart, have control of your product, and he says it helps to have someone keep you going and encourage you, and I think that's pretty much what we're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Just having
that's my main goal for this entire Discord server was to get people to work together and want to continue working on what they're doing. It
Great
helps
idea.
With productivity, and it also helps with mental state. Honestly.
Yeah.
Because some artists
socialize.
Don't have that outlet of socializing in the real world. Actually, most artists don't. We're all very much introverts.
Yeah.
So, it gives a nice little outlet.
About the introvert life.
Yeah. Introvert for life.
Sad. Oh, man.
I really wish you were kidding. But I don't see myself liking people anytime soon.
Yeah, at least not artist people.
Yeah.
Or people who just aren't open-minded. I think that's where it comes
from. Yeah, that's a good point. That, and I really cannot stand people who whine and cry about how their life is going.
Yeah, that's
like,
that's just,
That's the most annoying thing that anybody can talk about to me, is, oh, well, my life is just complete crap, and I don't like it, and I understand, like, from a depression's point of view, because I have depression, that, yeah, you can feel like your life is complete and utter crap, but I have that depression, and I have bad depression, but I just sleep it off. I don't talk about it. It's just like, it's another day. It's just a little bit shittier. I'll get over it.
But I think every day gets better, and like, if you do like reading too, like whenever you read something good, I could recommend you some books that'll put you in a good state too. Like, I have to go back to books as well whenever I get in that like mental rut.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have to put them in Discord whenever I'm done sketching. But
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. And I want to. The thing is, like, I've always tried to figure out how to like navigate that too in my life.
Mm-hmm.
Books, movies, people. I think people too. Having people that helps a lot.
Yeah.
It's like a nice social coffee burst, expressive burst of happiness, kind of. But people for me, I get tired of people quick. Like, I don't know, like, if I'm around people for too long, I get drained.
Weird, yeah.
Man. I just get drained.
Yeah, I get that mentally feeling drained.
Too. Yeah, Tefram, yeah, join sometime. Man.
Yeah, absolutely. We can get the link for you. Do you know how to get a link on Discord?
I do not.
Okay, go up to the text channels on viewer chat, right click. And instant invite.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's on viewer chat, you said?
Yep.
Okay. There we go. I'm just going to give you a link. I think this one has a timer on it, too. So
yeah,
if you don't have your stuff set up right now, yeah, dude, you could come on any other time.
Mm-hmm. You can also, when you do that, there's advanced settings. So if you want to put a longer time limit, like the max they have is 1 day. Don't ever use the never, because we don't want spam bots and things like that.
Okay. Advanced settings, never. 1 day. Okay.
Yeah.
There
so
we go. So I'll generate
you can do it that
one.
Way too.
There we go. And I'll put the. I'll whisper it to you, but it might show up in the chat anyways.
Yeah, I only send the permanent one over email and to people that I've talked to in person, or at least online, with voice chat and everything. So,
yeah.
It just, one, it protects my computer because I'm running the server on my computer, and two, it's just helpful.
Yeah, I feel you. Smart. I'm having a hard time whispering him. I keep hitting that whisper icon when I click on his name. Is there like a command you can type in to the chat? Like /whisper?
I don't know. Is there a command for that, Snowy? I think if you do /help, it'll tell you all the commands.
Okay. Give me a second, guys.
Let's just throw a little bit in here so that it's bleeding off the page. And that's something to keep in mind when you're doing art too, is like some artists will put tape around the edges of their paper. That way they can continue drawing off the page. That way things look fluid.
Yeah, that's a good technique. What'd you say, Tefram? You can't remember which Twitch? If you're talking about the Twitch channel, this is Taylor Olivas.
Oh, are you watching this both?
Oh, is it?
I don't know.
Yeah, so it'll be on mine, Taylor Olivas. I'll try to send you one.
You didn't really miss much. Just finished the first two colors. For the top of the sand. That's about
oh,
it.
Oh, he's talking about the Twitch commands. Okay.
Past that,
yeah,
we were rambling.
Not allowing me.
That's about it. That's pretty much all of our streams are just us rambling.
Pretty much, yeah.
I did a collaboration today, well, a collaborative stream, I guess we could call it, because it wasn't exactly a collaboration with Amp Studios, which you'll meet him tomorrow.
Oh, is he an admin?
Yeah.
Nice.
And I'm finding that I really like this whole Discord thing even more every day.
It's pretty great, man.
Yeah.
I like to just, like, pop in and see who's there.
Yeah.
Just every now and then.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so
and now that we actually have people talking, it's so great.
Yeah.
Because the first 2 weeks, nobody was actually talking, but we had, like, 15 people on here, or however many we have that are on offline.
Yeah, we have so many people offline right now. Or online. Or online, but not actually in the chats. But, Tefram, I sent you a message. It's not a whisper, but I sent you an actual message on Twitch. So maybe go into your inbox or something, and it should be there.
So is there a command to do a whisper?
I was looking at all of them and I couldn't find one. This is a good amount of cool little commands.
Oh yeah, I completely agree, Snowy. Ramblings can be really good because I listen to podcasts all the time and that's all they are is just people rambling.
Pretty much, yeah.
But it's really good to have that background noise. Okay, let's figure out our next two colors. I think I want to go with a bit of a lighter color. A bit more orange and a bit more greenish. Maybe a bit more blue to it too. Let's see how that looks. That looks good. And we're just going to kind of scatter these all throughout. Kind of give it a nice grainy feel by doing this.
You didn't get it. Let's see, guys.
Trying to get us to use technology properly is.
Yeah, especially me, man. I'm so bad at it.
Like a couple of old men in really young bodies.
Here's Discord chat. And here's a Gimp. Oh, it sends. Sent.
Yeah.
Successfully sent.
With the temporary one, you're more than welcome to post it in your Twitch chat.
Okay, yeah, just put it in here then. There, problem solved.
And just type in the chat whenever you get in that you're a viewer. To say, I am a viewer, or something ridiculous like that.
Yeah.
That way we can change your role. Which I still need to change the name of that to no longer being viewer admin and just be viewer. I don't feel like working tonight.
So, do you know exactly what that meeting's going to be about tomorrow? Just weekly goals and stuff? Or?
Introducing you, talking about how many people join the chats and talk. I'll probably mention something about the viewership and user base on the Discord. Just general stuff, really. Nothing to be worried about or anything.
Cool.
Chris might announce that he's doing something special to the site. He might not. All just depends. They're very relaxed for the most part until I start talking because I'm all business.
Business man.
Oh, that looks amazing. Okay. I think I want to add something to fill in the gaps though. So let's go with this same color. Let's go a bit darker to it there. How's that look? Yeah. I fill these. Will that be too much?
Oh, you typed in the Discord chat.
Oh.
Hello, I am Tefram 34.
Do, 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 do. Tell no lies. Rolls. Viewer. Alright, you should be able to join now. I think. Permissions. Viewer. Yeah, you can connect and you can speak.
Except TNL is my game.
Hello. You may have to change your audio settings. Oh, wrong chat. Wrong channel. Just messing everything up. All right, Snowy Blossom, thank you for joining us. You have a wonderful evening.
See you, Snowy.
If you're here tomorrow, we'll be on at about the same time, I'm sure. Maybe a bit later, maybe a bit earlier. Don't really have a schedule, so.
Did that work?
That did.
What's up, man?
You are extremely loud, but yes, it worked. One second.
I'm sorry, I had my mouth too close to the mic.
Oh, it's on my end.
Yeah, you sound good on my end.
Having all sorts of issues here. Alright, you should be better now. So what are you up to there, Mr. Tell No Lies? Mr. Tell No Lies, yes. Words. Working on anything spectacular? Or awful?
Wait, hold up. I'm gonna change my volumes real quick. Because now you're silent for me.
Yeah, same here. Let's try that.
Alright. I think I fixed it. Yeah, so what's going on, man?
Awkward silence. Awesome.
Love the silence.
And now I'm just throwing this wherever it fits. Not really having any sort of pattern in mind, just kind of doing it. And letting it overlap wherever it wants to go. Sure. Why not? Yes,
yeah.
We can.
Oh, clear.
I was just wondering if you guys were professional or students.
I don't know. I know you're about to go to school, so.
Yeah, I think we both kind of cross the lines between like professionals and students. I guess we can be considered both.
Yeah.
But I know Jake has done more client work than I have, that's for sure.
Yeah, and I specialize in 3D modeling. Not very art. I don't have a whole lot of background in art at all, honestly.
Even though sculpting is a very artistic method to use.
I guess I've just never really considered it as an art form until recently.
Well, it definitely is, man.
But yeah, I guess that makes sense.
So you're on the sculpting end, and most of my work too, you see me doing a lot of digital on Twitch, but most of my commission work has been done through like traditional paintings. I showed Jake the one I did today.
Yeah.
I ended up finishing it. Probably my most expensive and longest commission, honestly. So it feels good to get that out of my life. It's gonna be fun, but like when you don't have too much power over your design, it's like not too pleasing to do.
Yeah. Thankfully, most of my commission work has been me talking with my client for a good probably 3 hours on what they want and the story behind everything. That way we have the same idea.
Right. Yeah, that's important.
Which I think is a really good thing to do if you are doing commission work, is find out what the client wants exactly and try and hold to that.
Yeah, instead of spending hours making a product that just be like, oh, that should be a different color.
Yeah.
And you're using paints.
Mm-hmm.
That you can't change. But how about you, man? Oh, hey, new follower. Sabergan, thanks, man. Appreciate it. The homie. Hope you're having a good night.
Everybody's a homie now.
Everyone is a homie. But we're almost done completing the sketchbook page. There's probably a couple areas I can fit some stuff in. But,
look at all that blank space.
Different.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I have a bunch of blank space, man. Everywhere. Everything's gonna have to be black by the time I hit this. But Tefram, do you do professional work, or are you a student, or are you not even an artist, or where are you at?
I gotta be on the page or not. I'm an artist. I have done some professional work. I mainly do specialized in portrait work. But I've also done design and stuff.
Sweet.
A lot of the stuff I have done is for per client. Like, I do like memorial portraits and stuff. But I was going to school and then ended up deciding to do like self training because there's so much information online and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, I don't know. I'm kind of inconsistent with it, so it's kind of hard for being professional. But I do get some clients.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, that's...
Do you have a link to any of your work online, or
On DeviantArt, I have it's the same name as in Twitch, is Tefram34, and I have other stuff, but most of my work's posted there.
Okay. I'll check them out.
Awesome.
Give you a watch.
So do you stream at all?
I have to be on Picardo, I guess, for it to work. I do, I have done a few streams on Twitch,
mm-hmm.
but I used, about a year ago, I used to be on Picardo.
Oh, okay.
And stream there for about a year and then kind of got burnt out on it.
Yeah.
Kind of wanted to get back into it and try the Twitch thing, but I don't know yet. We'll see.
Yeah, I'm trying to avoid working tonight, so if you want to be the walking ad this evening, you're more than welcome to, Taylor.
Oh, wait, what's that? Sorry, I was checking out Teflon's work for a second, so I kind of blanked out a little bit.
Oh, no problem. We actually are part of a streaming community called Watch Me Work.
Yeah, let me send you a link.
And basically, it's very relaxed environment where if you want to stream, you can. And we're trying to build a nice, decent community of artists and professionals to come and work and have that outlet to find what they really are passionate about.
Cool.
So, if you're interested.
Yeah. I sent you a link in the Discord if you want to check it out, but man, these are really amazing portraits. Like, these are really good. Yeah, these are legit, dude. Are these all digital? Because some of them actually look like they have a charcoal feel to them. Like, very traditional charcoal-like paintings. Got a lot of work too, man. We'll put a link in Discord for you, Jake, if you want to check out his work.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm gonna show it on stream, apparently. Holy cow. Wow.
Yeah. Right?
That is amazing. Yeah, I have the same question. Is this all digital, or do you do traditional
work? The one you posted right there, of Beatrice, she's a singer, French-Canadian-French singer.
Mm-hmm.
That was drawn in my paint. I usually do, well, not usually. All my stuff is usually in open source programs, because my main platform is Linux. So I just use the tools that I got. And so, I kind of advocate for Linux anyway, so.
Oh, wow. Well, you have some skills. That is definitely true. Wow.
Yeah, man.
Thanks.
How long have you been doing, paintings and digital work? Or just, doing art in general?
About 2010, I started using a computer. And that's about when I started doing digital art.
Awesome.
I was, probably till 2012, I was doing more traditional, and then the scanning and cleaning up was such a pain. I'm like, you know what? I'm just gonna do digital, so I don't have to do the cleanup and stuff. But for clientele or whatever they want a portrait done, then I'll do traditional work. But for getting my work out there and being able to post it, it's just easier digital.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I agree.
So you said that
revision
too
is so much easier to do. Revision, iterization. Sorry, Jake, I just cut you off.
No, I was trying to cut you off, so it's all good. So you said that you started basically when you started doing computer. Did you start from a traditional background, or did you slowly move into that?
I've been drawing since I was a kid. Mm-hmm. And so it was mainly the stuff that I could afford, which was pencil and charcoal.
Mm-hmm.
I did some painting, but not too much. So that's why I was saying before, I have a lot more background in grayscale, but I'm much better at it, and then I struggle with color. But yeah, my father-in-law had a printing business, and he introduced me to using the tablet, the Wacom tablet.
Oh, okay.
And he actually gave me my first one, and then gave us a computer, and then I started from there. And then I wanted to learn about computers and learned about Windows and Linux about the same time, and I just preferred Linux. But And then it just went from there.
Awesome.
Kind of the same route I went through. Traditional than digital. I feel like the artists that I know who started out traditionally had like a little bit of an upper hand.
Mm-hmm. I kind of feel that's the same.
Tools.
Yeah. Because you get the feel of what the brushes actually do.
Right. And you have like more dexterity with traditional, or like you cultivate it faster.
Mm-hmm.
See, I tend to take longer because I tend to do paint like or draw like I'm doing it traditionally.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of using filters and all this stuff, I like using the transform tools and whatnot to make my proportions like fix it faster and whatnot. But for lighting and shadows and all that, it's done by hand and usually like on one or two layers.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah. But I need to get out of that route too, because like Photoshop is so powerful. Something shortcut wise.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, that's why I've been doing most of my art, because I'm purely from a digital, like I haven't really touched traditional in probably 10 years. Yeah, about 10 years since I was 11. So. All of my background is in digital, so the way I've been learning how to do paintings and this pixel art that I'm working on is just by spending as much time as I can to learn what works and what doesn't. So I'm kind of pseudo doing it traditionally, I guess, is the best way to describe it.
When I think of traditional, I think of like traditional tools, but like I completely get what you mean, because like the way I'm learning traditionally, like learning the fundamentals, getting the fundamentals out of the way, and it's a lot cheaper to learn digitally, I think, than traditionally, because like, if you're trying to learn color, you don't want to be spending $20 to $40 a tube for oil paints and have to buy a whole set for like either like a Rembrandt palette or Zorn palette, which can cost you upwards $100 to $200. That and all the other materials, canvases, like when you can just buy Photoshop or get a program like Mischief for $20 and get your laptop, take it outside and study color that way, it's a lot cheaper. But mixing, like, there's other aspects of it, like mixing colors and understanding the chemistry, how they work together, like the natural harmonies that you get from color. That's one thing that you can't learn in digital.
Yeah.
And that's a big reason why I went digital, because of the expense. It offered me way more tools that way in digital regards than if you did it by traditional.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and digital is becoming more and more portable. Like, that's the cool thing. Like, with the new tablets that are coming out, even though they're expensive now, they're going to go down in price.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, you could just go anywhere now and do, like, virtual plein air, that's what they're calling them now. So you just go out and do plein air paintings and get all the information you need for, like, a full-blown painting. If you wanted to do, like, say, still life or landscape, or if you just wanted to study color and use that for your color palette, so much easier.
In the grand scheme of things, this looks like I've spent way too much time on it, but I'm going to post a picture.
Did you put it in Discord?
Yeah, I'm going to do that now.
Okay.
I'll just do a screenshot. I don't think I have any information up here. No, we're good. Yeah, I posted in the viewer chat.
Check it out.
Now you're working in Gimp, huh?
Yeah. Free software.
Yep. Have you tried Krita yet?
I've looked at Krita. I've played around with Krita, but for what I do, it's kind of too much of a steep learning curve.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it took me a while to get used to Krita, because I went from MyPaint, which is very basic. It's kind of like, well, I haven't really used Mischief yet, but that's Vector, but it's kind of straightforward.
Mm-hmm.
You have the infinite canvas, and it's just the tools.
Yeah.
It took me a couple years to get used to Krita. And then even now, they got even way more tools and filters. But there's some pretty good YouTube videos on on how to do, especially if you're doing pixel art. There was some pretty neat tutorials on that and techniques to help you out.
Oh, okay.
Because they have they have like for comic artists, like brushes and settings for doing the comic book kind of thing, like for manga and what's the other
yeah, a couple of my coworkers use Krita just for that feature alone.
Yeah, but it's Krita's like more towards painting than Photoshop. Photoshop's got like got it all, right?
Yeah.
And there's a lot to it. But Krita, that's what I like about it. It is painterly and it has that traditional feel. And
I think I'm looking at the work that people have made. It's pretty amazing, man. Like, and that's free.
Yeah.
That's an open source. It started out in Linux, of course. It was a native application, and then what, like 2 years ago, they released it for Windows and Mac, and they've just really been upping the
Alrighty, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed, and if you have, please be sure to like, follow, subscribe, all that fun stuff. But yeah, I've been JakeHB, and again, thank you so much for Snowy Blossom for your follow. Past that, you guys have a wonderful rest of your day, and take care.